compose that?
Sorry?
Did you compose the music?
I didn't compose the music.
Testing. I didn't compose the music, but I wrote the lyrics.
Oh, wow. Wonderful.
Yes, and I'm very inspired by the lyrics. It's actually not recorded yet. And so when I go out and perform it, it's you're getting it, and it's not, haven't been recorded. It's not on wax yet. So it's a special song to me. It represents Africa to me. You know, when I think about 2020 vision, it's about having a vision that even though I'm not on the actual continent, because I'm from Africa and it's in my blood and my ancestry, I carry it with me wherever I go. And so that's kind of what the song is about. And knowing that no matter where you are, Africa is in you. So the land is mine, no matter where I go. And so that's why I love the song.
Good job.
Thank you.
Okay, next we have my brother Tarek Hussein, who is going to enlighten us on the northern part of Africa. And he is very passionate about sharing information and also about community activism to fight for justice for people in the Houston area that often get misunderstood and mistreated. And he may speak on that as well. So I'd like for you all to do is welcome U of H Clear Lake's very own Dr. Tarek Hussein.
Thank you so much, Kevin. This is really a wonderful event. Looking forward every year to come and see wonderful people here. I really got inspired by a speech of Dr. Joseph and Carol, and also got time to spend with dear Professor Dr. Woodrow. talking about North Africa, when you look at me, you may not expect I'm from Africa, because this is the stereotype that people think that because of the color, you may indicate somebody from Africa or not. But truly, I am African. I'm African-American, originally from Egypt. I was born there, I've been raised up there. I was teaching in Cairo University before moving to the United States. I'm glad I made this choice because I believe that now I have a better opportunity to excel and help humanity. Everybody from certain root, we cannot forget our roots because without having strong roots, you cannot have strong branches. So that's why connection with Africa is in our blood. And just give you just a brief summary about what I'm talking about. North Africa geographically, talking about from Egypt to the west till Atlantic Ocean, Morocco. And south is mainly you find Sudan, and Libya, Algeria, and the Sahari, which is Western Sahara, is part of Morocco, but there is a debate. If you talk to people from Morocco, they say this is part of Morocco or Moroccan Kingdom. If you talk to somebody else from Algeria, for example, they say this is a separate country. However, mostly, as you see here, this is very much North Africa, Mediterranean Sea from the north and Atlantic Ocean from the west. Egypt is the only country has a piece of its land, Sinai, is in Asia. So this is just to let you know. So mostly on the Mediterranean coast, Egypt is the most populated, about 90 million people there. Unfortunately, 95%, you can imagine, live only on the strip of the River Nile, coming from Sudan up north to Mediterranean. It is the second most populous country in Africa, I believe, after Nigeria. See, we have to mention Nigeria here. And by the way, I have my best friend, Mr. Hakim Olajuwon. He is the basketball player. He was the MVP in 94-95. I don't know if you guys remember him. He's also from Nigeria. So, good people from Nigeria. North Africa, mainly people, because of the language, they speak Arabic language. They call them Arabs. But actually, if you talk to Tunisian, Algerian, Moroccan, they speak French more than Arabic. And the reason for that was, or is, because if you look at Egypt, Egypt was under British Empire. Libya was under Italy. And Tunisia, Algeria, Moroccan was under French. So that's why they speak more French than even Arabic. But Arabic is the main language in the school and in the system. So, the countries, as we mentioned, Egypt, Libya, Tunisia, Algeria, Morocco, and West Sahara. Unfortunately, after what's called Arab Spring, which started in Tunisia in 2011, early 2011, and Egypt, there are so many different forces now competing for the government or for the power, especially in Libya. And we have heard about what's called ISIS. And unfortunately, when you hear in the news the word Islamic State, please deny that, because they are not Islamic and they will never be a state. In terms of education, you're going to see there is always, in third world countries, you're going to see always a gender gap, mainly in rural areas because of lack of providing services, cultural influence. Some of it also go back to the origin of this, the origin of people in this land, come from what's called, you know, tribes. And when you look at any tribal formation, you're going to see it's like a patriarchal system. The man is the one who's responsible for the group to support and provide. Of course, you're gonna see illiteracy rate is high, especially among women. You're gonna see quality of education and academic achievement. Of course, unfortunately, if you look at the top 100 universities in the world, you will not see any of the university from Africa, unfortunately. There's also lack of applied research because lack of sponsors, you know. Applied research is a kind of research where you need a sponsor to, you know, to take on these projects. But unfortunately, we don't have that. This association, for whoever is interested to know more about, you know, childhood, is called Association for Childhood Education International. It also does some projects to help children. In terms of poverty, you're gonna see all kinds of poverty in Africa. For example, absolute poverty because of it's a chronic lack of basic food, clean water, health, and housing, especially in the desert area of any country in Africa. Relative poverty, members and families and society, no access to superior services because, you know, you see this gap really mainly in country like Egypt, where you see very, very rich people. I lived in America for 25 years now. My wife also working. She is a doctor of physical therapy. However, we cannot, when we go back to home to visit, when we look at these people who have these palaces, we wonder, we lived in America, and we, you know, we have income in dollar, but unfortunately, when you go back home, you see these people, you really wonder from where they got all of these wealth, you know. But again, this is because of the autocratic regimes always in these countries. Situational poverty, unfortunate event like flood. This is fortunate because we don't have this kind of poverty much because there is no like flood or no earthquake happens mostly in North Africa. Generational chronic poverty, of course, you're gonna see this kind of poverty also because people trapped, you know, in that kind of low class level. And the social mobility in this country is really hard. Upward social mobility is hard to achieve. Government, we understand, because after the Arab Spring, unfortunately, the anti-revolution forces were working really, really hard underground, and they were able to defeat the revolution that happened in 2011. Because we have to understand that a country like Egypt is controlled by military since 1952. Nasser, Sadat, Mubarak, and then Sisi right now. And it's amazing to see Sisi, S-I-S-I, is opposite of ISIS. That's amazing, right? Okay. But always you're gonna see the relationship between military and business people, what's called the triangle of power. You know, they love to control and they love to be the dominant. Unequal distribution of forces, always you're gonna see in these countries. However, the future of revolution is really unpredicted because if you look at, for example, French, the French Revolution stayed for 10 years. However, this is happened 2011, but still unpredicted. We don't know what's gonna happen. In terms of Egypt and its relationship with the United States, if you look at the history, you find during Ottoman Empire, before 1882, it was minimal dealing with the United States. At the time of Britain, was still minimal dealing. When Nasser came to power, everyone here in terms of, it was Eisenhower, they were afraid of Nasser because Nasser, he went to United Soviet and he tried to build up a relationship with these, communist countries. And the United States, they tried to limit Nasser power, not to, harm him, but to minimize his power and marginalize him. During Mubarak time, same policy, Sadat and Mubarak, they, after Sadat started what's called Camp David Agreement with Israel in 1979, because October War was 1973. Camp David 1979, after that the peace with Israel, we believe as Egyptians that peace is just on paper, because there is no really any signs of true peace, but after revolution 2011, again military coup, they were able to take back the country. So if you look at the Egypt-United States relation, you find during Nasser time, Omega Memorandum, that was a secret decision or a secret bill was issued by United States just to marginalize Nasser power because he was building up a relationship with China and he was seeking help from United Nations to build the high dam. Egypt at that time, the water comes from Sudan and it was like too much water to flood the country, so that's why there was an urgent need to build a high dam, and Nasser was able to get a loan from not from America but from other countries to build the high dam. So after that, Nasser also he nationalized the Suez Canal in 1956, and that of course caused some anger to France and British and Israel. So they attacked Egypt in 1956, and that's called the war. The three countries invaded Egypt and occupied part of Suez Canal cities. And until Eisenhower administration intervened and they withdrew their forces back. So Arab Springs, the last one, we have the last one? Yeah. The Arab Spring initiated in Tunisia late 2010 and in Egypt early January 2011, Libya, Algeria, but anti-revolution forces were able to take back these countries. Libya still under a conflict. It's a very big conflict in Libya between too many forces, fighting for the government. If you think that these revolutions have any have made any goal, have made any achievement. Unfortunately, like in Egypt, the regime right now is an autocratic regime, is even chaos more than even at the time of Mubarak. And that was the plan, is to make people feel sorry for these revolutions. So that's why we just have to help as much as we can and pray that these countries will get the freedom, you know, one day.
Amen.
Thank you.
Does anyone have questions for Dr. Hussein? He says he'll entertain any questions that you may have. Everybody knows everything there is to know about Northern Africa. No questions, no everything there is to know about it, right? No, just kidding. No, seriously, are there any questions? Okay, we had next on the agenda something, but I want you guys to do something here at this moment. Are the dancers ready back there? Can I get a wink? They're ready. Okay, so what I'd like you to do before we bring the band dancers up, I want you guys to spend just 30 seconds to a minute and just talk at your table about an issue that is that you think is urgent. And then I'm going to ask somebody to give us an example. Just 30 seconds to a minute, and with your table, just talk about an issue that you feel is pressing and urgent. So at my table over here with my friend Patrick, we said a major issue is poverty. Okay, what do y'all come up with? Anything? Oh, where did he go? Who's the leader? You have one? Okay, Muhammad's got something. All right, that's not the kind of issue that I was listening for. That's an issue. All right, anyone at this table? Any pressing issues? Everything in the world is just perfect, right? No problems at all. Okay, what was one of the problems that y'all come up with? Anything? Presidential candidates in which country? In the United States. They're all great, wonderful, right? It's hard to pick. Hard to pick between them, right? No. How do you mean? You mean you what?
Donald Trump. I'm sorry.
Not Donald Trump. Okay. All right. Presidential election. What about this table?
Same thing.
Politics has got everybody's mind. Okay, what about over here? We got the brain power over here. What you got?
About what?
About what? Problems. What problems did y'all talk about here?
Democracy.
What about democracy? What's wrong with democracy?
It doesn't work
everywhere.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Any particular place in mind? Can you think of that?
African countries or Arab countries. Right?
Arab countries and African countries, okay. All right, democracy issue. Anybody here at the back table? We got our lovely ladies. I'm going to defer a bit. Muhammad, do you have something?
Tribalism.
Ooh, okay. Tribalism is an interesting. We got politics, we got tribalism, we got poverty. I know Brother Devante got something. What you got?
I say an issue of morality and ethics.
Okay. I said security because of the security. I mean, you know, a lot of folks are afraid to travel and, you know, you're scared to go to the movies. I just thought about security.
All right, we got morality, we got security problems. What about over here? Our second country in Africa, by the way, is Ethiopia by population. My sister, 100 million strong thereabouts, right? Okay, everything good? Y'all come up with any problems?
ISIS and the global
in global economy. I don't know what's happening with this mic. Maybe it's a customer in the back of the room. Anything else? Everything's good? All right, good to see y'all. All right, let's get up next. All right, someone's here to perform, but they are not ready yet. And the person who I will call next has disappeared. Where did she disappear to? She's getting ready. Okay, which means that next, let's see here, who we have ready next? Dr. Baptiste there? Are you ready for your talk? Well, the dancers are deferring, so are we waiting for Miss Dominica Houston? Is that what we're waiting on?
She's in the back.
She's in the back? All right, so, any other topics that we have covered or we should talk about? You had something, Kelsey? Oh no, it's a private conversation. Anybody had any questions about any of the presentations? We're experimenting with the format for African Summit, as you can tell. We're going with presentations, we're going with performances. And we're trying to find the perfect mix of sort of performance, cultural expression, and then educational content. We're trying to find that perfect balance. People have different expectations, and so we're trying to find something that's gonna benefit the most of the people. I do appreciate the overwhelming support we're getting from the community, because I look around the room and a lot of people are here from the community, various parts of the community, the Caribbean community, I'm sorry, I just gotta give props because, hey, the island folks showed out today. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much. Thank you all so much. We have strong representation here. It looks like we had some representation from Trinidad. We had some representation strong from Haiti, Dominica, and let me look around, make sure I didn't leave one out because they'll really get on me. Where's St. Lucia lady here? All right, our friend from St. Lucia is responsible for the conceptualization of the designs of the decorations you see above us here, all the balloons and streamers. Sister Dion, we sure thank you for that. And I'm stalling, as you can tell, because I'm waiting on somebody to perform. Where's my little sister at? You want to sing? Oh, she shook her head. Okay, so I'd have to do it solo. I'm not going to do that. I think what we could do then is, if we're going to wait on our performer, does anyone have something that they'd like to talk about? I can just have the mic for a little bit. Okay, Dr. Joseph over here, you got something?
Well, I don't have anything per se, but this group had a very interesting conversation.
Hold on, let's get this on the mic.
The gentleman to my right asked, If Africa has so much wealth, and it does, Africa is the last economic frontier. Africa has everything. And he asked, well, why is Africa lacking in power and other resources for their populations? And it goes back to a statement made that the